ऑडियो एंड वीडियो म्यूट का बटन है, फिर स्टार्ट करते हैं।
गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, सो प्लीज म्यूट योर ऑडियो एज वेल एज वीडियो एंड लिसन हियर। So in the last class we are discussed what are the various chapters are including in that your second view accountancy syllabus. So now we can start that chapter, accounting for partnership. That chapter accounting for partnership under the basic concepts. So here, so accounting for partnership basic concepts. So in this chapter what are the things we need to discuss? So for here we can discuss few things regarding partnership firm. So here the partnership, first of all what is partnership? So in the chapter name only telling partnership. So here what is partnership? So let me know, first we will discuss about partnership. So here the first thing, what is partnership? So before that going meaning of partnership, so here what is the main motive of establishment of partnership firm? So before that commencement of partnership firm, there is an sole proprietorship firm. So here in that sole proprietorship firm, here there are only one person in the business operation. They only investing all the capital into the business as well as he only enjoying all the profits as well as losses in the business organization. So here few of the limitations of sole proprietorship. So we have established a partnership firm. So here the limitations of sole proprietorship, the first limitation, limitations of sole trading firm or sole proprietorship firm. So here the first limitation, so this is one of the drawback, this called as cons. Pros as well as cons means limitations of sole trading firm. In this sole trading firm, already you people are discussed in that previous year in that business study subject. So here we can discuss few limitations. So here the first limitation, it is an lack of capital. So in that sole trading firm, the first limitation, it is a lack of capital. So here in this business organization, they have only one person in the business organization. They need to invest entire capital into the business organization. So suppose the business becomes loss, so on that day they are not able to invest additional capital into the business. So this is what first reason for that, I mean sole trading firm. The second thing, continuous losses occurs in the business organization. So here each and every year might be there will be loss, there will be loss is on that day, they are not able to survive in the business organization. So this is what most, I mean this is what one of the disadvantages, I mean limitation of the sole trading firm. So here the next limitations of sole trading firm, lack of continuity in the business organization. So here there are only one person in the business organization, they are not able to expand business in different sectors. So that's why the limitation of the business, it was not wider area. So these are the few limitation of sole trading firm. So on this limitation they have established these partnership firm. So here let me know, now we can discuss in that partnership firm. So this is why limitations of sole trading firm. These limitations already you people sir discussed in the last year only. So this is what partnership firm in that our second PU as per the PU board NCERT syllabus. So let me know the first meaning of partnership. What is partnership? What is partnership or define partnership. So here the partnership, it gives the definition as well as meaning is. So according to section 4 of the partnership defines, according to section 4 of Indian Partnership Act. What is that Indian Partnership Act? The Indian Partnership Act 1932. So this is what very important thing. So here the meaning of partnership is, according to section 4 of the Indian Partnership Act 1932 defines. It defines
for all. So this is why meaning for that partnership.
Gagan Kumar and Lavanya. Soumya, sorry, Lavanya. Gagan Kumar and Soumya, please mute video.
Gagan Kumar and Soumya, please mute your video as well as audio.
Malayana.
Please mute your video. Soumya, mute video, ma'am. Don't look it here. Mute your video. Soumya, as well as Gagan.
Soumya, video on the camera option is not a ma. Adar mele click martaye. ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಡಿಸ್ಪ್ಲೇ ಮೇಲೆ ಕ್ಯಾಮರಾ ಒಂದು ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ತೋರಿಸ್ತಿದೆ ನೋಡಿ ಸಿಂಬಲ್ ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತಮ್ಮ
profits means, so when they are establishing they are establishing partnership for means on the time they need to bring a agreement between partners, agreement among the partners. In that agreement time, must and should they need to take some terms and conditions, that is a partnership deed. So in that partnership deed only they are mentioned regarding sharing of profits among the partners. So this sharing of profit sharing ratio on the basis of might be the capital investment ratio, otherwise according to they are not mentioning anything else means on the time the profits or losses sharing ratio might be equal proportions or according to their capital ratio only they can distribute in the business organization. So this is what second feature of partnership firm. The first feature it is that two or more persons in the business organization. But then second feature sharing profits among the partners. So sharing profits according to their agreement only they can share profits or losses in the partnership firm. So here the next feature of partnership firm. Business. The partnership firm must ensure it is on the basis of some legal business transaction on the basis of. So here terms and condition must and should they need to follow. So each and every business organization must and should they need to some legal business entities. So here this is what third feature of partnership. The first one, two or more persons required for construction of a partnership firm. Second one, sharing profits among the partners. Third one, business. So here in this business corporation some lawful business activities only they need to take in the business organization. Feature of partnership firm, that is an agreement. The agreement between partners must and should be carried as some legal business activities according to partnership deed. So here each and every business organization must and should the agreement is an compulsory. So here the agreement either may be either oral or written, but most of the business transaction the written agreement this is by mandatory. So either the agreement it is an orally or written agreement, but in this written agreement this is what comfortable for all the this partnership business activities. So these are the few things, these are the few features of partnership firm. The next and last feature of partnership firm, mutual agency. In partnership firm, the mutual agency, mutual agreement with the partners, this is what very mandatory and this is what very important feature of partnership firm. So in that partners, the agreement, mutual agency, the relationship between partners, the understanding, this is what very important thing. Because of in this business organization, all the partners might be they can involve day-to-day business activities. Otherwise, on the basis of their mutual agreement or mutual agency, so any one of the partners might be they can involve in the business organization. Any one of them acting for day-to-day business organization. So here, these are the five features of partnership firm. So let me know once again, the first feature of partnership firm, two or more persons, this is what first feature of partnership firm. Second one, sharing profits in the business organization. Sharing profits. So in the business organization, according to their partnership deed, the profits and losses sharing ratio, whatever the deed in that agreement, they need to follow that ratio. The next one, business must ensure it is a lawful business activities. So here, the next feature of partnership or agreement. So according to partnership deed, must ensure it is an agreement either orally or written, but most of the business may be they prefer written agreement only. The last feature of partnership for mutual agency in between partners, the mutual agency, this is what very important feature in the partnership business organization. So these are the few features of partnership firm. So this was very important question as per your 2 mark questions in that your annual examination point of view. So now already we are discussed what is the meaning of partnership and what are the various features of partnership firm. The next thing we can do the partnership deed. The next concept, partnership deed. What is partnership deed? The partnership deed, it contains, the partnership deed contains
partnership deed. So, and
all the partners duly signed. All the partners must and should signed in the above document. So as per the partnership stamp act. So this is what meaning for partnership deed. So let me now answer it. The partnership deed is a document which contain terms and conditions of the business like interest on capital, salary, commission and all the partners duly signed. All the partners signed and duly stamped according to the stamp act. So this is what very important thing for the 2 mark question. Partnership deed. What is partnership deed? So here, so in this partnership deed, what are the contents are included in this partnership deed? Let me now discuss about what are the various contents in the partnership. So here, once again, here partnership deed is a document which contains terms and conditions of the business like interest on capital, salary, commission and all the partners duly signed and as per the stamp act. This is what partnership deed. So let me now discuss about contents of partnership deed. So this is what very important concept. So in the partnership business organization, so in the partnership deed, what are the various contents are included in this deed? So in this partnership deed containing so few of the necessary terms and conditions. So let me now discuss the first content in the partnership deed. The first content of partnership deed is a name and address of the business organization. So this is one very important content in the deed. So here the name and address of the business. So here which business we are starting. So on the business name must and should be able to record in the partnership deed. Name and address. So in which address we are starting the business organization. This is one of the first content of partnership firm. The second one, the second content of partnership deed, name and addresses of the partners. The first one, name and address of the business. The second one, name and addresses of the partners. Maybe in this business organization, for example, the minimum number of members are 2, maximum 20. So in this business organization, either 2 or 3 or 4, whatever the number of members, must and should those who are involving in the partnership firm. So all the partners' address must and should be to stamped in the partnership deed. This is what second very important content in the partnership deed. The first one, name and address of the business or firm. Second one, name and addresses of the all the partners in the business activities. The third content of partnership deed, nature of the business. So here, nature of the business. So in this partnership firm, they are commencing which kind of business, that business are related to either manufacturing company or some other companies, either bags company, whatever it may be, the nature of the business, which kind of business they are establishing. So this is what very important content in the partnership deed. So this is what third content of partnership deed. The next content of partnership deed, sharing of profits and losses ratio. This is what very important in the business organization. In this business organization, in which manner they are sharing either profits or loss in the business organization. So here, normally the profit and losses, they are calculated at the end of the during the period only. At the end of the year means either, I mean, December 31st or March 31st, in this assessment year only they are preparing financial statement. So by the way, they are preparing this profit and loss account. So by the way, preparing this profit and loss account, easily we can identify either true profit or loss of the business organization. So already we are prepared in the last year in the financial statements only, preparation of balance sheet as well as profit and loss account. By the way, preparation of this profit and loss account, we can ascertain the true profit or loss in the business organization. Either profit or loss in the, whatever the profits or losses we are ascertained by the way of preparing this profit and loss account, that profits or losses, they can share according to their profits and losses sharing ratio. So here the ratio, it is on the basis of mutual agreement or mutual agency, on the basis of their investment capital only, they are distributing their entire profits and losses in the business organization. So this is what one of the very important deed, I mean content in the partnership deed. The next content in the partnership deed, commencement, the date of commencement of a business. The date of commencement of a business, this is what very important content in the partnership deed. So then they are establishing the partnership firm. So this is what beginning of the date. First thing should be to record this establishment, commencement date in the partnership deed aspect. The next content of partnership deed, duration of the business. The next content of partnership deed is a duration of the partnership business. So according to their agreement, how many years they are running the business, so on the basis of their agreement, maybe either 10 years or 15 years or 20 years. So on the basis of their agreement only, they can run the business. So this is why duration of the partnership business organization. The next content of partnership deed, the mode of appointment of auditors. So here, each and every business organization must consult delegated auditors, because of the auditors only preparing financial statement. The financial statements including profit and loss account, balance sheet, cash flow statement. So these financial statements preparing on the company auditors only. So here the mode of appointment of auditors, so on the basis of either full time auditors or on the basis of agreement period only. So this is what one of the content of partnership deed, the mode and which manner we need to appoint the auditors into the business organization. So in this detailed information easily they need to record in the deed only. So these are the few things including in the partnership deed. The next content of partnership deed. The next important, very important content in the partnership deed, the rights, duties and obligations of partner. So here the rights. So what are the various rights to the individually each partner? So here the rights. So rights as well as duties of partners as well as obligations. So here obligations means nothing but liabilities. So here for that each partner, what are the various rules, I mean responsibilities as well as duties and rights. So this is the all the rules master should bring to record in the partnership deed only. The next to partnership deed special content it is an the next special content of partnership deed, the ninth one it is an maintenance of accounts in the business organization. So here the accounts on which manner they need to maintain either on the basis of single entry system or double entry system. The recording of business transaction we have two types. So single entry system as well as double entry system. On which manner they need to record in the business day-to-day business transaction. So this is what very important content in the partnership deed. The maintenance of accounts in the business organization. The next one. Maintenance of bank account. the maintenance of bank account, this is what one of the content of partnership day. The maintenance of bank account, the bank account, whether it may be the savings account or current account or recurring account. So on which account we need to maintain it in the business organization, this was very important content in the partnership deed. Business agreement. Finally, the fund has to be closed down. So, on that day, the dissolution of fund, on which manner we need to close down. This is what very special content in the partnership deed. So, here the mode of dissolution of a fund. So, here the dissolution of a fund, there are two types: dissolution of a partnership and dissolution of a partnership fund. So, here dissolution of a partnership means, so here all the partners are terminating from the business and the firm has to be continuity. So dissolution of your firm is the partners has to be cut off their connection with the firm and the firm has to be closed down. So in which manner the firm has to be dissolution. So on which manner we need to close down the business. So this is what very important content in the partnership deed. So these aspects are specially included in the partnership deed. Next very important special content in the partnership deed means the mode of admission of a partner at the time of admission of a new partner into the business. So on that day, what are the various situations, what are the various causes to admit a new partner, this is why very important content in the partnership deed. On which time need to admit a new partner. So on the same way, retirement of any partner. So at what time you need to retain a partner from the business. So like examples, in case of any partners or any partner has a change of residency or some other legal activities. So on that day, we need to retain our partner from the business organization. So on the same way, death of a partner at the time of death, it is an uncertainty. So on that day, so how we need to close the books of accounts, these are the various aspects. So we need to record in this partnership deed special aspect, the mode of admission of a partner or retirement of any partner or death of a partner. So these various circumstances we can record in the contents of partnership deed. So these are the few things, these are the few contents of partnership deed in the business organization. So let me know once again, the partnership contents are, first one, name and address of the firm. Name and address of the firm. Second one, name and addresses of the partners. Name and addresses of all the partners, not only one partner address. So we need to take all the partners' complete and detailed address we need to record in the partnership deed. The third content of partnership deed, nature of the business. So on which kind of business we are establishing. So either manufacturing company or some other company. So which kind of, which nature of business we are doing, that is very important in the business organization. The next content of partnership deed, sharing of profits and losses sharing ratio. The sharing of profits and losses on the basis of their capital contribution. So whatever the capital invested by the each partner, so on that basis only they need to distribute according to ratios. The next one So here for that interest on capital. So this was very important content in the partnership, right? Interest on capital. So in this business organization, must ensure each and every partner, they need to invest some capital into the business organization. So on the capital, they can expect interest on capital. Because of all the partners investing capital into the business, even though they are taking profits in the business, but they are investing capital into the business. So that's why they are expecting interest on that capital. So here, interest on capital, at what rate of interest we need to take? So this was very important. And the same thing, loan. Suppose in case of any partner taking a loan from the business organization, means on that time, the loan settlement, or what is the rate of that loan? So interest on loan. So on the basis of either 5% or 6% on the basis of terms and conditions in the partnership deed. But they have not mentioned anything else regarding interest and loan. Means normally the fixed rate is 6% per annum. But annually the rate of interest on loan is 6% only. Suppose that agreement they have mentioned either 5% or 4% means, so we can fix that one only. Otherwise the rate of interest on loan means 6% per annually. The next one, drawings. Suppose first of all drawings. So here, what are drawings? Drawings are, it is an the owner withdrawn from the business, the amount or goods or something withdrawn by the owner from his business. So here, for that either money, either cash or near money assets they can withdraw from the business means on that time, they need to pay interest on such a drawing. So this is what very important. So here, the manner of interest on capital, interest on loan and interest on drawings, such kind of things we can record in the contents of partnership deed. So these are the few contents in the partnership deed. So in this session we have discussed what is the meaning of partnership. Either meaning or definition both are same. There is no confusion in this one. Either meaning or definition. Second one, what are the various features of partnership? The next one, what are the various, what is the meaning of partnership deed? And the next one, what are the various contents of partnership deed? So these are the four things in the partnership. The next thing in this partnership work, so what are the accounts we need to maintain? The next one, organization, we can prepare on the basis of two methods. So one is fixed capital method. Fixed capital method or fixed capital system. The capital accounts we can prepare on the basis of two methods. The first method, fixed capital method or fixed capital system. The second one, fluctuating capital system or fluctuating capital method. So here, these are the two methods.